Hey guys, the new DLC for Borderlands 2, The Viper Sanctuary, is out. And in this DLC, we have found a way to farm a red chest loot crate over and over again really rapidly. This red chest is one of the more rare chests that you can find in Borderlands 2, and it has a chance of spawning high-rated gear ranging from white all the way to pearlescent. So the first thing you need to do is get into the DLC, obviously, and get to the Mount Scarab Research Center area. You need to run all the way through this area and get to the end where you meet up with Cassius. Cassius is one of the bosses that you will be fighting and defeating in the main storyline missions in this DLC. It doesn't take very long to get to this point if you're just doing storyline missions, and you do have to defeat him to gain access to the area that has the red chest, and then from there you can farm that thing like crazy. Once you enter the biolab and you go across to the other side, there's going to be some vines that are blocking this door the first time you go through it, but the second time there's just going to be this metal door here. And once you kill Cassius, that door will immediately open, and then you can get to the red chest. It's just right around the corner. So go through the door, make a left. You will see this fast travel right here with two crates on either side. One is the red chest and the left is the gray chest. And this area right here will be blocked off if you've already gone to that sanctuary location and defeated Hector. So once you have walked up to this fast travel, it has now created a new save point so that you can farm these chests and back out and come right back in and spawn into this spot. One thing I was hoping for with this spawn location is that you could go back in and fight Cassius right around the corner and farm him, but this door is closed and you're locked in this small area. If you want to get back into the fight with him, you got to go to that other spawn point way at the beginning of this research center. So again, this is going to be the fastest red chest farming you're ever going to find in Borderlands, because all you have to do is quit out, come back in, open the chest, and then repeat the process over and over again. Now, if you're on PC, this will go really fast because the loading screens are really short. But if you're on console, it's going to take a little bit longer. So I farmed these two chests a lot, and I got a lot of the purple epic gear. I got shields and relics, mods, grenade launchers, snipers, all of it. About every fifth time you farm it, you're going to get some iridium and some money along with some relics. In addition to the purple epic gear, you're going to see a lot of the E-Tech magenta colored weapons, the shotguns, the SMGs, the pistols, and rifles. And because you can farm this chest so rapidly, it's a lot easier to get some of this really rare gear out of it. I got a few legendary items. I got some grenades and a sniper. And before this DLC came out, the cyan pearlescent colored weapons was the highest tier you could get. Now it's effervescent. And I don't know if you can get effervescent from this red chest. I'm going to keep trying to find out, but you can get the tier below that, and that is the cyan pearlescent. I was able to get an Avenger SMG, and I also got the Tunguska rocket launcher. My guess is that if you are able to get an effervescent out of this red chest, it is going to be extremely rare. But again, I'll keep trying, and if I do get one, I'll tweet it out and let you guys know. But I hope this helped you guys out, and we'll see you next video.
Awesome!